It is time for another quick revision session. This time it is going to be a poem, Crossing the Bar, written by Alfred Lord Tennyson. I am Ma'am Shomi and I have brought for you more than 35 multiple choice questions. Question 1. Crossing the Bar is a poem focusing on transience of life, finality of death, immortality of man, old age. The right answer is transience of life as well as finality of death. Options A and B. Here there is a mention of immortality of the soul but not immortality of man. Crossing the Bar was written in the year 1889, 1888, 1801, 1898. The poem was written in 1889. The poet was 80 years old at the time and was down with a severe illness from which he eventually recovered. The illness, however, made the poet ponder on death as he himself was very old and nearing his time. Question 3. Alfred Lord Tennyson uses the metaphor of crossing a sandbar to represent dash in Crossing the Bar. Soul, salvation, death or rebirth. The right answer is option C, death. Question 4. What is the mood of the speaker in Crossing the Bar? He is mournful, he is sad, he is anxious, or he is filled with tranquil optimism. The right answer, the poet is filled with tranquil optimism. Question 5. Sunset and evening star and one clear call for me, and may there be no moaning of the bar when I put out to sea. Question 1. Crossing the Bar opens with a metaphorical image focusing on sunset and evening star to immediately suggest that something is coming to an end, night is approaching, stars are twinkling in the sky, the sun has set. Well, the sun has set and night will approach and stars will begin to twinkle in the sky. But if we take into consideration the metaphorical image, the right answer will be option A, something is coming to an end. Question 2. What is evening star? The planet Venus, the moon, the pole star or the clouds? The right answer is option A, the planet Venus. Though it is not clear what Tennyson's intentions are specifically, the evening star is traditionally not a star at all. It is the planet Venus. Compared to other planetary bodies, Venus moves through the skies quite quickly, making it a kind of wandering star. Well, this suggests the journey of life. Keep this in mind, the journey of life. Now let's come to question number 3. Which literary device is used in Sunset and Evening Star? Assonance, alliteration, anaphora, both B and C. The right answer is alliteration. Sunset begins with S, star also begins with the consonant S. Question 4. Which marine term is used in the quoted extract to mean the announcement for the sailors and seafaring men to set out? Mourning, call, put out, sea. The right answer is option B, call. It is an announcement for the sailors and seafaring men to set out. Question 5. What is the symbolic significance of one clear call for me? Impending announcement of the poet's departure from the present world to the next, a command from the captain to fix the mast, a call to reach the deck of the ship, go back home. The right answer is option A, impending announcement of the poet's departure from the present world to the next. Question 6. If sandbar is a symbol of death, with the water inside representing his life, that means the poet's life, what does the water beyond represent? The afterlife, dreams, hell or grave? The right answer is the water beyond the sandbar represents the afterlife, option A. 7. The poet wants to put out to sea without moaning of the bar, sound and foam, evening bell, the flood. Again, it's option A, moaning of the bar is the right answer. And one clear call for me is an example of alliteration, hyperbole, simile or onomatopoeia. The right answer is alliteration. Clear call. C, clear, and call also begins with C. The next one, 9. What does call foreshadow later in the poem? The role of Greek gods and goddesses, the role that God will play, the idea of a heavenly afterlife, both B and C. The right answer is option D, both B and C. Question 6. Too full for sound and foam is an example of transferred epithet, alliteration, simile, anaphora. The right answer is alliteration, full and foam, beginning with the consonant F. What kind of death does the poet want? Smooth, quiet, near seamless transition, all of the above. The poet wants smooth, quiet, near seamless transition while he is dying. So the right answer will be all of the above. The next one, the phrase turns again home shows waves lashing on the seashore, ship returning to the harbor, waves as originating from the boundless ocean, briefly touching the shore only to return again to the depths of eternity or buried in the ground. The right answer is option C. Waves as originating from the boundless ocean, briefly touching the shore only to return again to the depths of eternity. Human beings are born, they spend time on earth, they live their lives on earth, and they again return to the depths of eternity after death. Option C is the right answer. 9. The words boundless deep symbolize unknown eternity, core of the earth, vast sky or river. The right answer is unknown eternity. Boundless deep signifies sea and it symbolizes the unknown eternity. Option A. Next, an extract for you. Question 10. Twilight and evening bell, and after that the dark, and may there be no sadness or farewell when I embark. Question 1. The expression evening bell is symbolic of funeral ceremony, ringing of the church bell, knell, which is sounded when someone dies, ringing of bell for morning assembly. The right answer is option C, knell, which is sounded when someone dies. So, evening bell is associated with death. Question 2. The expression twilight and evening bell has replaced. After that, the dark, time and place, sunset and evening star, or when I have crossed the bar. Twilight and evening has replaced sunset and evening star. It's option C. There is fading light after the sunset and the evening bell is announcing the end of the day's activity, suggesting the old age and the end of life. And soon there will be darkness, that is death. And the poet wishes that there is no mourning when he dies. Question 3. And after that, the dark. What does dark stand for? Death, state of inertia, sleep, or a vegetable existence? The right answer is dark stands for death. Option A. Which word does not symbolize old age? Sunset, twilight, dark, both A and B. The right answer is option C, dark, because dark, as discussed, stands for or symbolizes death. And you may not be an old person, but you may die. Okay, so dark does not symbolize old age always. Like in the second stanza, the poet again emphasizes that there must not be any sadness, mourning, sad goodbyes, all of the above. What is the right answer? The right answer is all of the above. He does not want any mourning. He does not want any lamentation. 11. Where will the ship of his soul return after it is dark? That is, after he dies. Infinity, harbor, island or earth? The right answer is infinity or the unknown eternity. Option A. Question 12. The evening bell announces advent of darkness, the end of day, time to return home or a sound sleep. The right answer is the evening bell announces the advent of darkness. What is the poet doing here? Anticipating his death, he has died. Anticipating the death of someone who is a stranger or simply passing his time. The poet here is anticipating his death. Question 14. What does the quoted line not suggest? May there be no sadness or farewell. He is leaving with a quiet and calm mind. He is prepared for his journey. He is seeing death not as a final destination, but a new beginning. He does not like the company of family, friends, and relatives. Well, in the question, I have not suggest. So the right answer is option D. This line does not suggest that the poet dislikes the company of family, friends, and relatives. He is leaving with a quiet and calm mind. He is prepared for his death and he is seeing death not as a final destination, but a new beginning. The poet has accepted his reality. What are they? Inevitability of death, ephemerality of life on earth, eternity of soul, God as his solace. What is ephemerality of life on earth? Impermanence of life on earth, transitoriness, transitory nature of life on earth. And eternity of soul? The poem reinforces our faith in the immortality of soul and the existence of God. In this question, all the options are correct. I did not give you all of the above. I should have given that to you, but I am really sorry. So, if you get such a question, you will give a tick on all of the above. I am sure you will have that option in your question paper. So, this is just for practice. Keep this in mind. The poet has accepted the fact that death is inevitable, that life on earth is transitory or ephemeral, soul is eternal, immortal, and God will be his solace. Question 16. What is the flood symbolically? Problems, sufferings, death, or happiness? The flood stands for or symbolizes death. For though from out are born of time and place, the flood may bear me far away. What is the poet's belief? Afterlife, judgment, rebirth, or paradise? The poet believes in afterlife. It's option A, afterlife. Now, the next question. The word pilot is a direct reference to God, angels, captain of the ship, one of the members of the crew. The right answer, option A, God. Question 19. The poem ends on a positive note. Which of the following does not justify this? This optimism or this positivity? The poet has accepted the finality of death. The poet is hoping to meet God in afterlife. The poet has prepared himself for death. The people are bidding him sad farewell and mourning. The right answer is the people are bidding him sad farewell and mourning. Sandbar is the barrier that the ship will have to cross when sailing out to sea. What does this barrier symbolize? Perilous rocks, turbulent weather, lashing waves, impediments, internal and external, that we have to overcome to journey into death. The right answer is impediments, the hardships, internal and external, the obstacles that we have to overcome to journey into death. 22. The nautical reference in the poem is heightened by the reference to the sandbar, clear call, tide, all of the above. All of the above, option D is the right answer. Question 23. Why does the poet look forward to the journey from the earthly to the spiritual realm? Death brings with it a new kind of knowledge and experience which is not available to the living. Death leads to a reunion with God. Death leads to forgetfulness, or both A and B. The right answer is both A and B. Death brings with it a new kind of knowledge and experience which is not available to the living, and death also leads to a reunion with God. The next question. Which theme is not mentioned in Crossing the Bar? Death, acceptance, marriage, Christianity. Marriage, C, is not mentioned in Crossing the Bar. 25. Which of the following is not a metaphor? Sunset, an evening star, clear call, pilot, or foam? The right answer is foam. In 26, what kind of a poem is Crossing the Bar? Elegy, lyric, fable, both A and B? The right answer is option D, both A and B, elegy and lyric. It is a short lyric, though in a way it is an elegy as well. The next portion is something different. It is not in the form of multiple choice questions, but I felt that this portion is really important for you. Imagery, a discussion on the imagery used in the poem. Don't skip this. Sunset and evening star, visual imagery. Morning of the bar, auditory imagery. Twilight and evening bell, visual imagery as well as auditory imagery. Twilight, visual imagery, and evening bell, auditory imagery. And the journey motive is very important. Journey of the soul after death to the unknown world, its home, from where it came to this world. Well, my dear boys and girls, this is the end of today's discussion. I have tried to incorporate as many questions as possible. Read the text thoroughly so that if you get any question, you can answer it with ease and confidence. Again, I wish you all the best, and please take care of yourselves.